When I first saw this anime, I thought this was full on. But instead of being, it was more,
it's amazing.
Well, actually, it's,
this is fucking awesome.
Sprinkled with a little bit of, and I think that's just an amazing mix. I would call Gleipnir a sleeper hit, but that would only count if I was asleep on a highway and an 80-wheeler woke me up in an isekai. Jesus Christ, why did no one warn me how great the show is? I just found it because I saw a clip I liked on YouTube. So yeah, I'm here to gush over Gleipnir and show how to do a memory loss anime. Gleipnir is a show that follows a boy named Shuichi, a seemingly normal high school student, and according to the internet, the number one soy boy. Aside from the fact that he starts out as a huge wimp, he can turn into a living mascot. Yes, Shuichi has the ability to turn into what this series calls monsters. Yeah, really imaginative names, but sometimes simplicity helps. In this monster form, he gains a few abilities, like super strength and a good sense of smell. With that power, he notices a girl in a burning building, who he promptly saves and almost rapes her. Psst. This becomes important later on. Her name is Clair. World's most relatable character, with a smile so devilishly sexy, I can hear the pants of a thousand weep titan in unison. And she discovers Shuichi can turn into a monster, and they become besties, get into a suicide pact, and try to find Clair's sister, who is also capable of turning into a monster, and murdered Clair's parents. A seemingly simple premise at the start. An overtly aggressive girl coerces a more timid boy into going after his sister. Fairly normal for anime standards. And that's the kind of series I like. Simple at the start, but more complex the more you read into it. But our heroes soon find out that there is way more to everything than they originally thought. Aside from Shuichi and Clair's sister, there is a whole plethora of monsters that all are originated by participating in this coin search game, set up by a crashed alien. During his space travels, this alien crashed on Earth and lost all of its crewmates in the process. This alien race is capable of changing its body into energy, which is stored in coin-like items. If someone finds a coin and brings it to the abandoned hotel, the alien will give monster powers to the person who brought the coin. The person, however, can choose what type of power they'll get, as it depends on their deepest desire. The more clear the desire is when gaining the power, the more control the human will have on their monster form. Some even remain human because they have such a clear view of what they want to become, and others become a monstrosity because all they really wanted was power. That leads me to another thing I should discuss, the powers and abilities. At first, it seems the fight will just be people with superhuman strength beating the shit out of each other. But it quickly changes when it's revealed that some monsters have special abilities. It gives a JoJo stand-esque feel, but instead of having a humanoid ghost floating out of your ass with special powers, they turn into monsters that have special powers. This way, the battles feel way more tactical than just a good old slugfest. Now, we have been a few minutes into the video and I hear you all thinking, you haven't mentioned the title! This has nothing to do with the memory loss story! But oh, it does. See, Shuichi can't remember finding a coin and bringing it to the alien. At first we think, well, maybe someone else gave him his monster power. But the more we learn about Shuichi and his past, the more we start to think that he's not remembering it all. It starts off with the interaction Clair's sister Elena has with Shuichi. She talks like she knows him. We also see one of the later introduced characters refer to Shuichi's childhood friends. Only for Shuichi to say that he had no childhood friends.
And I think we can all agree to that feeling, right?
Now at this point, memory loss is all but speculation. Elena could be crazy stalker, and that's why she's familiar with Shuichi. Maybe someone gave the power to Shuichi when he was asleep or something. And this one person could be mistaken with Shuichi and his childhood friends. But all our speculations are shut down with a particular flashback. And this flashback isn't even important for Shuichi.
And we as the audience were just happy that Shuichi was included into the flashback.
But it shows that Shuichi indeed had friends in the past. That he indeed knew Elena. And that even before he met Clair, he had connections with the alien, as one of his old friends, Honoka, was the instigator of the coin hunt game. So we just found out in almost 10 episodes in that it's indeed a memory loss story, without even the main character knowing that he lost his memories. So our next question is, how did Shuichi lose his memories? Well, it may be obvious to some, it's a great revelation for the audience that indeed Shuichi has gaps in his memories, and even Shuichi eventually finds out that there are gaps in his memories. And that feels very natural. Instead of the contrived, who am I? What is my name? I know nothing anymore, until one of his brothers is murdered. Because in Gleipnir, most of the time the audience knows more than Shuichi, it makes it all the more gratifying when he finds out more about his past. One of the things I looked forward to in the anime and still am looking forward to in the manga is Shuichi's past with Elena. Because we know that they were more than just friends, and it is heavily implied that those sexual rapey urges that Shuichi has towards Clair is because Clair has a similar scent to Elena. And since all his romantical memory of Elena is locked, that similar smell triggers a primal lust in him. Because you might be able to make someone forget something, but you can never take away the way someone feels about someone. Also, something I want to mention before ending the video. In the manga, the very first page is dedicated to Shuichi angrily choking Clair, declaring her to be a demon. Now, at first, we might think it's a flash forward, foreshadowing a falling out the two might have. But because of the whole memory stuff, this might also be a flashback. Who knows, the manga still hasn't explained every question, but I highly recommend reading it. If you are okay with the occasional full frontal female nudity and some blurry furry cock. If not, totally check out the anime. The voice acting is great, the animation is passable at some points and top notch at most fights, while also having some amazing plot points. Big anime titties and ass.
Also small anime titties for the more close people. And that's it for today, people. Hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, hit the like button. And if you want to be up to date with every time I upload a new video, be sure to subscribe. I'm Dirkcoin, and thank you for watching.